Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. Just like I promised in my Thor Lightning tutorial, today I'm going to show you how to do the Thor Flying Hammer effects. This is going to be a very simple tutorial because all you have to do is just be worthy of the hammer, like me. Or I can show you how to do this in After Effects. So if you want to follow along, feel free to download the project files in the description below. And now, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so here is the plate that I will be using, and it's just me in front of a green screen extending my hand forward while holding the hammer, and then I swing my arm backwards pretending like I just caught the hammer with my hand. So this hammer catching effects consists of two primary steps. First, we are going to remove the hammer at the beginning here until I swing my hand backwards, and then during the part where the hammer is erased, I will have a 2D image of just the hammer flying towards me. But before we do any of that, I want to make my hand blow back here to be more impactful, because the hammer is flying super fast. So let's go to the frame where I catch the hammer, and then remove the next 3 frames after this to make the blowback more violent. Use Ctrl+Shift+D to split our layer, and we want to shave off the first 3 frames of the duplicate and bring it forward. And now if we play back our timeline, you can see that the hand swing is faster and more sudden, giving an impression that the hammer is really fast and heavy. So now let's trim out the ending part of this composition to remove the empty layer at the end. And now let's pre-compose these 2 layers. And then what I want to do is to add a marker just before my hand swings backwards. And there we go. So next, we want to erase the hammer. Let's begin with removing the head of the hammer first. And we want to remove that by bringing back this background texture that is currently obscured by the hammer. So let's duplicate our plate precomp and let's rename it Green Patch. And then we want to find a frame where the texture behind the hammer is revealed. And then we want to freeze frame it, then create a mask on where the head of the hammer was. And then let's go to the marker and Alt close bracket. So now this is what we have. So what we will do next is to remove the handle on my hand and on top of my jacket. However, for the hand on the jacket, there are a bit more steps. For example, the clean patch on my hand will need to be motion tracked. And so will the patch on my jacket. And not only that, when we start patching our footage, we're gonna have our patches covering objects that aren't supposed to be removed. Like how this green patch here is covering my finger. So what we want to do is to create a mask for that finger as well as other parts of the hand that will be covered by the patches. So before we patch up our plate any further, let's create the aforementioned mask and tracker. So let's add Mocha to our plate and click the symbol. And now in Mocha, I want to track and mask my hand here. And of course, we're just going to track and mask the beginning part of the plate, just before my hand swings backwards. So let's go to frame 4, and we want to track the general movement of my hand. So let's grab a texture here and disable the scale and rotation, because we just want the translation data, and let's track backwards. Great. Now let's rename this spline as Tracker. This spline will be used to motion track the cleaned up patch of the hand later. And we want to disable it from view and disable it on the gear also, just in case so we don't accidentally retrack it again. Now let's start masking the hand. And because all the hammer elements are behind these 4 fingers and my palm, those are the part that we want to mask. So let's go to the frame just before my hand swings backwards again, and let's create a spline on the shape of my palm, and then track it backward. And then we want to fix the spline shape to make sure that the mask is following the outline for the entire frames that we tracked. Okay, so once that's done, let's rename it and disable the gear icon again, and let's track the fingers. Okay, so now we have all of our masks, let's close and save. Back in After Effects, let's duplicate our plate, put it at the very top, and rename it Hand Mask. And then on the Mocha effect, let's go to Matte and create AE Mask. And there we go, we have created a mask layer of our hand. Now let's press MM to fine-tune the mask a little bit so the edges are a bit softer. And then once again, trim it out right when my hand swings backwards. Then let's export our tracking data from Mocha. Create a null, name it Hand Track, and then let's go to the Mocha tab again, and on Tracking Data, click Create Tracking Data, and let's select our tracker. And then on the Export option, set it to Transform, and the target to hand track null, and then apply. Perfect, so now we have our tracking data for the hand. Just to pause the tutorial for a second, recently we just reached 70,000 subscribers on this YouTube channel, which means we are getting closer to our 100,000 subscribers goal, and we cannot thank you enough for your support. So keep subscribing or hit the subscribe button if you haven't already to help us create more great tutorials like this one. And now, back to the show. Now, let's start cleaning up the hammer on my hand and the jacket. Something that you could do in your own shot is to shoot another plate of your hand without the hammer. That way you can just extract a texture from your empty hand and use it to patch your plate. But for this, I didn't shoot any clean plate, so we are going to invent our own. We could do this process here in After Effects, but it is much easier to do in Photoshop. So let's go to the first frame here and solo our plate, and then go to composition and save frame as, and we are going to render this out as a JPEG, PNG, PSD, whatever floats your boat. And once that's rendered, let's open the file in Photoshop. Okay, so the first thing we want to focus right now is creating a clean patch of my palm here that got obscured by the handle. So for the palm, we don't have any texture for that. So what we can do is to use the clone stamp tool to slowly patch up the handle in between the fingers. And if that is not enough, we can grab a texture of my entire thumb using a lasso tool and then layer via copy and use that copy to patch the handle. We can also duplicate that again to fill in more space. And then using the eraser tool, we want to remove the hard edges and create a good seam on the textures so they blend together well. And then use the clone stamp tool again to clean things up a bit. Okay, so we have cleaned up the handle on my hand. Don't worry about all the fingers that are covered because we already have the mask layer to restore them in After Effects. So let's save as and save this as a JPEG and bring this to After Effects. Now in After Effects, on the first frame, let's bring our hand clean plate here and put it just below the hand mask. And we want to isolate only the part that we clean up. So create a mask and feather it a bit. And then we want to parent it to the hand track null. And then of course, let's trim the layer so it disappears when my hand starts swinging. And this is what we have. Now for the jacket cleanup, we're gonna do the exact same thing. Let's open the still frame on Photoshop again. But this time, we need to restore the parts of my shoulder and the jacket under my hand here. Thankfully, on my original footage recording, I actually found one frame of me just standing without my hand up. So what we can do is to extract some texture from this to help clean up my jacket. So let's bring in this image, and I want to grab the shoulder to patch my plate, and then we want to clean up the edges, and then mix them all together with a clone stamp tool. And then I want to grab some texture from the bottom part of the jacket as well and use clone stamp tool to clean things up a bit. And once we're done, let's bring this back to After Effects and once again, bring it below the hand mask and then let's isolate around where the hammer was. And there we go. Now we need to have this jacket patched to follow the movement of my body. So let's go to the tracking tab and track this contrast on my jacket and then create a new null. Name it body track and apply our tracking data to that null and parent our jacket patch to it. And there we go. Now let's trim the layer again and this is what we have. One last thing I want to do is to add the flying hammer. So here is an image of just the hammer that I have cleaned up in Photoshop. So let's mask out our hammer here and bring it below the hand mask. And then we want to go to frame 4 and add keyframe to position and rotation. Move back a few frames and move it off screen and rotate. And there we go. Lastly, let's trim it and turn on the motion blur. And this is what we have. Once you are done with the shot and you want to remove the green screen out, we have several tutorials on green screen keying on this channel that you can check out. And after that, you can add lightning effects to your shot like I have shown you on the previous Thor lightning tutorial. All the link for this in the description below. And of course, the lightning effects that I used on that lightning tutorial can be purchased on our website at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library
and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. But most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, there are other resources on this channel, such as other VFX tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and many others. So be sure to check them out as well. Let us be your number one resource for visual effects. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.